Hello there everyone in YouTube land. I'm back to show you guys the results of my flat iron that I did. This is day 3 of my flat iron. Today I decided to kind of put my hair up. Just gonna show you, give you a 360 today. Okay, that was my 360. And I will be inserting some clips and some pictures and some videos of how my hair looked on day 1 of my flat iron. I did that video and I found out, or I realized later, that my sound was off. So I did that video, just messed that video up, but it shows you guys the clip of how my hair looked on that first day. And I have pictures of what I did on the second day. That one is I pin curled it at night to maintain, well, to get that, achieve that look. And I'll show you pictures of the pin curls that I did. And I put a satin scarf on it and it stayed pretty well. Now that first day, when I first did it, I had a lot of, well, I had body, and it showed my length because my hair was straight. Well, sort of straight. It was like, it was a little frizzy. It was starting to frizz up a little bit when I first did it. And I thought it was just gonna be a frizzy mess like the last time I did it. Well, like the last flat iron that I did. The last flat iron I did in December. Oh my goodness, guys, it was a hot mess. And I ended up doing a bantu knot out that night. Still frizz city on my last flat iron in December. And then that next day, I tried to bantu knot it out again, and it just was not working. I ended up having to wash my hair like the next fall, like in the next 2 days. I had to wash my hair because it was tangling up so bad. I mean, plus it was very humid during that time. It was raining. It was just, it was pretty bad. So my hair did not flat iron well. Plus, I have mentioned before the mistakes that I made on that first flat iron. I did not deep condition my hair. My hair was not properly moisturized. I did not use a heat setting high enough to get my hair straight. My hair was straight when I first did it, but as I was doing my hair, I could see it. When I do one strand or one piece, I could see it drawn up when I went to the next piece. So My last flat iron was horrible, and I don't think I used the right products, and I definitely didn't have the moisture that I needed. But this time around, I'm very, very happy with the results. I'm just loving it. It's so straight and silky. I almost feel like I got a relaxer, guys. Not saying that a relaxer is good or anything, but I just haven't seen myself in straight hair in so long. I mean, hair this straight. It's been almost 3 years since I've seen hair this straight, and it looks very healthy. I ended up having to clip my ends. I clipped about a half an inch off, and I will show you guys how much hair I lost throughout the whole process. And I will show you how much hair I clipped from my ends. And I clipped about a half an inch around my whole entire head. Some areas was a little less because it needed less, but I had some single strand knots on the ends of my hair that had to go. And I may have had a few split ends, but my hair just felt really bad on the ends and it was not curling. When you flat iron it, you can tell what ends need to go because they don't curl up and they feel very rough. So once I got rid of those ends, my hair started to curl. Well, it was already kind of bumping at the ends, but it curled better and it felt better on the ends. And I know those single strand knots are gone from the problems that I had when I was doing wash and goes all the time. So I used some products. I first started using a couple of products that I did not like. I'm going to do a product review of some of the products that I used, or of all of the products that I use. But I know for sure there's quite a few products that I am going to use every time I blow dry or flat iron my hair. And there is a conditioner that I just fell in love with. It was just awesome. So I have some pretty good results, I feel, of my flat ironing, and I'm loving it, guys. Don't get me wrong, I love my big hair, I love my natural hair, my natural looking hair. This, to me, this is not natural looking, this looks relaxed to me, but there's nothing wrong with that at all. I'm loving it, I'm rocking it. The only thing I'm scared about, I'm afraid of heat damage, and I said this before, I've always been afraid of heat damage, but if I have heat damage in my hair, I'm not going to worry about it. I'm just going to work with it and do the best that I can, because I just wanted to see, could my hair get straight, and how would it look, you know? So, because I've tried this a couple of times before. The first time I flat ironed my hair, it turned out okay, so-so. I'll show you guys a picture of that. But the second time was horrible, and I just didn't think my hair could get straight, or as, you know, straight as this. So, but I was wrong. So my heat setting on my flat iron was, I think I used maybe 385 degrees. Below, I used the Jill Berry. And I don't know the rest of the name of the flat iron, but it was a Jill Berry flat iron. And it has a heat setting of 25. And I think it goes up to 450 degrees or 425. It goes to 4 something. So I did the back on 20, because the back and the sides are a little bit coarser than my top and my front, and some parts of my sides are a little looser curl. But I used a hotter heat setting on the back because it's a little coarser, and I think it can take a little less heat. On the front, I used about 19 or 18 on the front. So I think that's it. If I think of anything else, I will come back to you guys with it. Or if you have any questions or comments for me pertaining to my flat iron and what I did, then just let me know. And I'll either try to make another video or I will answer you back as soon as possible. So this is my results, and thank you for watching. I'll see you guys soon.